everyone, welcome to the Maybelline Makeup Loft. My name is Janelle and today I'm going to teach you how to achieve long-lasting makeup. We're going to be using long-lasting makeup from the Maybelline makeup range and I'm going to be showing you tips and tricks on how to make sure that you can make the makeup last as long as you can on your own skin. And not only that, we're going to really test this makeup to see if it lasts 2 hours of me playing sports. If you'd like to see more looks like this, don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel. Leave a comment below letting us know what you'd like to see next. And don't forget to give us a little thumbs up as well. Anyway, let's get started into this look. So the first thing we're gonna do is make sure that we have completely prepped our skin. Prepping your skin is the most important part when it comes to making sure that you achieve that long-lasting makeup. So I actually have normal to dry skin. So I like to make sure that I use a moisturizer that's a little bit more nourishing, a little bit more creamy, and the emollients are a little bit more buttery as well. With a creamy moisturizer, this is gonna make sure that my long-lasting foundation is not gonna look dry and it's gonna look smooth and fresh. If you have oily skin, I recommend a more lightweight moisturizer. Maybe something with a bit more of a gel texture, something that's not going to make your skin feel more oily. The next step to prepping your skin is to make sure you apply a good base. The base that I'm going to use today is the Maybelline Face Studio Primer. This is a hydrating primer, which, like you guys know, I have dry as desert skin, so this is going to be perfect. I'm going to apply a pea-sized amount onto my hands, and I'm going to apply this all over the face, focusing on the center of the face. This primer especially helped to smooth out my skin a little bit, give me a tiny bit of hydration, and fill in any pores so that the foundation will look flawless and last that little bit longer. For foundation today, I'm going to use the Maybelline SuperStay foundation. It lasts up to 24 hours and it has a full coverage. So if you need some long-wearing makeup, this is where to go. With a long-lasting foundation, you definitely want to make sure that you find one that's got more of a natural matte or matte coverage. Now, the reason why is because it's going to take longer for your oils to break through that full coverage and that matte texture, and therefore the foundation will last a little bit longer. When you're blending things in with a sponge, I recommend damping the sponge first so that it doesn't soak up too much foundation. And if you do dampen the sponge, make sure that the sponge is not too damp. I find that when a beauty blender is too damp, it tends to change the formula of the foundation and therefore it won't last as long as it's originally intended to. Making sure I have all areas of the face. It's really important that when you have full coverage, you cover any areas that might change color as well. Otherwise, you're going to look really discolored. So what I mean by that is make sure you really get into your hairline, really get around your ear and onto your ear, and not to mention your neck. The foundation color that I'm using is nude beige. Don't forget to apply foundation on your eyelids. And straight into concealer, we're going to use the SuperStay Full Coverage Under Eye Concealer. And this color is in light 15. I've purposely chosen a color that's a little bit lighter because I want to have a little bit more of a contoured and highlighted look. For a long-lasting makeup, it's a great idea to apply a little bit more concealer than you normally would because full coverage means that there's more makeup to wear away. So I'm applying that underneath my eyes, just onto the side of my nose. This is going to help contour my nose a little bit later. And just the center of the forehead. Back in with my sponge. And you can see that color has really lifted that area. Now I'm gonna really sculpt and bronze that skin and I'm gonna use the City Bronzer. And this shade is in medium warm. Just with an angled brush, I'm gonna swirl the brush into it and really find the hollows of my cheeks and blend upwards. Oh my God. This bronzer smells so good. I'm also gonna apply it around the ear and jawline. So if you are a little bit stuck on contouring and highlighting, the best trick is to make a 3E shape. So 3 and E. I don't know if that's mirrored in the camera, but you get what I mean. And really press that into the temples. There's nothing worse than not blending all the way up into the hairline, so don't forget to get straight in there. If you have a larger forehead like me, don't be shy with the bronzer. And for the last step for the skin, we're gonna really make sure that that foundation stays right on by baking. So to bake today, I'm gonna use the Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder. So baking is a technique that really makes sure that you set your makeup. When the makeup is set so much with powder, that oil is gonna take so long to break down your makeup. And therefore your makeup's gonna last a lot longer and it's gonna look a lot more matte as well. This is gonna be especially great for those oily girls out there. So just with the product in the lid, I'm gonna grab the sponge and dip it right into the powder. And I'm going to set my oily areas. So for me, that's around my nose, I like to try to avoid my under eye areas because I do have dry under eyes and I don't want that area to be accentuated. I like to go on the sides of the nose as well because it's just going to highlight and contour that nose a little bit. We're also going to apply this on the center of the forehead. I tend to get oily eyebrows, so I'm just pressing that front part of my eyebrows. And then I just like to go underneath my contour as well. I tend to touch my cheeks a lot, so I want to make sure I set that area. And because I do have that dry skin, I'm not going to let that sit for too long, so I'm just dusting that away. And now that baking has really sealed in all that makeup, and I know that this is going to last. We can't contour without highlighting. So we're gonna go in with the Master Chrome, and this shade is in Molten Gold. Love this color. And just with a small blending brush, I'm gonna apply this onto the top of my cheeks. I'm also going to apply this on my cupid's bow and my nose bridge. You also wanna make sure you get your brow bone and your inner corners. To lock it in place even more, I'm gonna go in with a setting spray, and this one is the Lasting Fix. So this is really gonna make sure that the makeup is sealed all in. I like to think that this is going to make the powders look a little less powdery as well and just lock everything in place. And you can see my skin looks a little less dry. Now I am feeling a little adventurous with my eyes, so I am going to do a winged out green liner. So I'm gonna bring you in a little bit. For this green winged eyeliner, I'm going to use the Tattoo Liner Gel Pencil. These eyeliners are so long lasting. So knowing your eye shape is really important. I know that I get super oily in this inner corner, so I'm gonna make sure that I focus most of this wing on the outer corner. And with the green eyeliner, we're also going to bring that just onto the outer third of the bottom lash line, making sure we connect it to the top wing. Just to make sure that there's no creasing with my hooded eyes, I'm going to put a little bit of powder just where I know I'll crease a little bit. I just like to tap that into this inner corner bit here. Just make sure that there's no transfer. This will just help to make the eyeliner last a little bit longer as well. I'm going to go off camera and put some mascara on, and the mascara I'll be using is the Lash Sensational and in Waterproof. And I'm just going to vamp up this wing by adding some half lashes just at the end. Last but not least, we are going to do a lip. And to make sure that the skin and the eyes are the focus, I'm going to go really nude with the lip. And so for the lip, we're going to use the SuperStay Matte Ink, and this shade is in Driver. So to really test that this is long-lasting makeup, I am actually about to head off to volleyball training for 2 hours. And I'm gonna be sweating, I'm gonna be running, I'm gonna be screaming, and we're gonna see how well this foundation lasts. So I will check in with you guys really soon. So I am back from my volleyball game, and let's take a look at how this makeup has lasted. So I'm gonna zoom you guys up. Okay, so I just came back from not 2 but 3 hours of volleyball. So it was a lot of sweating, a lot of screaming, and literally not 1 ounce of oiliness at all. And if we look even closer, we have tiniest little bit of creasing here and the tiniest little bit of creasing here. But other than that, 3 hours of volleyball, absolutely flawless to the T. Oh, amazing. A little bit of creasing in the eyeliner, but that's to be expected with my eye shape. Other than that, I mean, looks like I never left. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you liked this video, how to create that long lasting makeup. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe, leave a comment down below, or even give this video a little like, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.